and I are here to talk to you about the resources for our recent paper called Simulation Technique and Mathematical Basis for Faster AC Analysis for Power Factor Correction Boost Converters. I know it's an exciting title. I'm going to show you where to get the resources that we have for this paper so you could try them yourself, and I'll walk you through the simulations to show the results. So first of all, what you can do is go to my lab's website, parislab.net. If you go to the main one, you can then click on tools, and it has the tools for this paper, okay? And these are the simulations. They have the control loop, the input impedance and output impedance. These are all simplest files for them, and you can download them here. So click download here, and you should be able to open that up here. It has these files in there. These are the simplest files here are the ones that actually run it, but you do need these other things. So just download the whole thing and export it. Then all we have to do is make sure you have simplest ready to run. And let's open this first one. So this is looking at the control loop using an AC source as the input. And what we're trying to do here is look at the AC analysis. So here is our schematic. And to run the AC analysis, we are going to be looking at, if you go to simulator, choose analysis. If you download these files, everything's already ready to go. So you can just press simulate. But I'm gonna just show you what it's set up to do. We're doing the AC analysis, and this means that we're gonna be looking for a transfer function at the output. In order to do that, it needs to have pop. So pop is the periodic operating point, and this allows it to go into steady state so that it can actually do the analysis of the AC and see how does the magnitude and phase change for a certain input and output. Okay, so you have that set up. Here's some timing already here for how to activate pop. Here we're assuming the AC, so we need to have a long enough period to go over the full AC, the half wave of the rectified signal. And then for the AC here, you can set up what like frequency you want to start, like from where to where. And then usually we do a nonlinear sweep, logarithmic, and then how many points per decade. If you increase this number, you'll have a more accurate plot, but it'll take a lot longer to run. Let's just keep these settings for now. So you can press either run directly or OK. I'm going to press OK. I want to point out a few things about the simulation. So in order for the pop to initiate, it needs to have a pop trigger. Here you can see the pop trigger is right below, it's attached to the AC side. For AC source, you need to have the pop attached there. Here we're looking at the control loop. So this is our output voltage. It goes through our voltage compensator first, then it has a feed forward term that's multiplied, and then we have the current compensator. So this is the dual loop system, or two compensators. And what we're doing is we're breaking the loop and then seeing how when we have a small perturbation in one part, when it goes through the loop, how does it come back out? So that's here. So you can see here they're in and out defined. Actually, you just need to look at what's in. So in is one side and out is the other. And then we put our little AC source here. This is the one that's going to add that little perturbation specifically for AC analysis. Okay, so with that, we can run this and ready, go. This is the pop-up you'll usually get, and it will tell you how long it's going to take. And it's going to take some time. It's found pop, which is what it's showing. So it, when it finds that, it's going to like output this. And this is showing the first rectified waveform. And you can see actually it's going to do, I think, two or three periods here. And that tells us that it's found that point so we can actually do the AC analysis. Now it's actually running the different runs, and it's going to take some time here. So we'll be back. 2 minutes later. Now we've seen that this has completed the simulation. It pops out the plot, so we can see the gain and the phase plot for the control loop. And that's great. So this looks great. This is the full AC analysis for the control loop of the converter. That took a little bit of time though, right? So let's see how long it would take if we do the DC analysis. So replacing this with the DC. Luckily, all these are already set up for you, so you can just run them. So if we go back to here, we're now going to open the DC one. I'm just going to move this over so you can look at this. This is the same, all the parameters are the same. A few things are different, pretty much two things. We have the input now is changed to the DC and is changed to the RMS value of the AC wave. The pop trigger is moved because if it's on the DC source, it won't have any perturbation. There's no changes in it. So we move the pop trigger to a very steady repeating signal like the gate driver. So we can put the pop trigger there. And then we have our AC perturbation voltage source here, and then the input and output defined here for the AC analysis, which will output our Bode plot. Let's look at this. This is also, this analysis is actually all almost the same. The only thing that's different is that the maximum period now is switched to a much smaller period based on the switching of the converter. So that did change a little bit. AC analysis is all gonna be the same. So here we can press okay. And actually we're ready to run. So let's run this. Oh, there it is. This is the pop. Oh, and there it is. There's the AC already popped out there. So this is the AC. Let me just show how long that took. So here's the elapsed time. That took 19 seconds. The other one, we waited at least 2.5 minutes. So 19 seconds, a lot faster. These are two AC. So this is the AC from the using the AC source. And this is the Bode plot AC analysis output from the DC. So this shows that you can do it so much faster just using a DC source for the control loop. Now we'll move on to the output impedance. So let's go back to our downloaded files. I already have the output impedance ready for you to go. All right, here's our output impedance. And we have our AC source pop trigger moved here again. And this time we're looking at output impedance. So we're looking at the output current relative to the output voltage. And then our perturbation is a current in parallel here. All right, and our current is measured down here, but it's the output current. All right, so if we run this, this is going to be the AC. We're going to let it run, and it's going to take a little bit of time. So we'll be back again. So here we can see that the pop was established, it was reached, and so now we're just outputting the inductor current, the steady state over the half line rectified cycle. 3 minutes later. And here we have the plot. And this is the Bode plot of the output impedance and the phase shown here. So that is very exciting. It took how long? It took 3 minutes and 46 seconds in total. So took a little bit of time. Now let's see how the DC simulation, how long it takes and how it looks. Here we are. So here's the DC simulation. So we have our DC source, our pop trigger is moved to the gate signal, and we are again looking at the output impedance. So the output current and the output voltage are sensed here, and then the output current is perturbed. I'll just show you the analysis one more time. It's changing the period here. It just makes it find pop more efficiently, and then the same range. So actually I'm just gonna press run, here we go. So fast. So it's found pop already, and it should be popping out the plot very soon. Here we are. Bring this status window back up. Oh, already done. So about 20 seconds here, and we get the same plot. So between this plot and this plot, pretty much exactly the same. So between those two, definitely chooses the DC one because it's a lot faster. Now, what about the input impedance? That's another thing we might want to measure in a PFC. I have those files ready as well. Here we can go to Z in and we can look at the AC one first. So I've opened that. Everything's set up the same, pop triggers over at the input. And now we're looking at the input current and the source voltage was the input, the AC voltage. So that's what we're sensing over here. And our perturbation for the little AC source for AC analysis is put in series with the AC source. And so let's run it and see what happens. So run. Here you can see that the pump hasn't been established, so it outputs that, so you can see that. And we have a little bit more waiting to do. 5 minutes later. Okay. It took a while. It took 6 minutes, but we did get a lovely plot on the output. And so here you can see the gain and this interaction, this little peak here is the interaction with the line frequency. And we have like the input filter shown here, but we get a lovely AC plot. It's beautiful, lovely. So this is the input impedance. Say, well, that took way too long. I agree. Can't we just replace that with the DC like the other ones? Well, let's see. I did set that up for you as well. So if you go to this one, double click here, we tried. So we put the DC here and we still have the AC perturbation in series with that. We moved over the pop trigger to be on the gate and let's see what happens. So let's run it. We expect it would go a lot faster because it's DC. So we run it. Pop is established pretty quickly. So it's over here in this ramp. And it should relatively quickly give us the AC response. So exciting. We get an output, but something a little different. So between the DC source one and the AC source, they're actually pretty different. And we can see that the low frequencies, this phase is zero, but for this one, the phase is negative 180. So they're totally different, to be honest. They're not at all the same. So even though this DC one was super fast, it's not the same. So for the input impedance, you cannot do the DC trick. It's not correct. So you have to actually do the AC one, and it does take a long time, but it's really important to understand that input impedance interaction, especially, it's really hard to model this interaction with the line frequency. So simulation is really important there. So if you want to try for yourself, you can go to the Paris Lab website and download the resources. We also have some figure files if you want to look at those from the paper. Please cite us if you use any of these. And you can download them. You can try out the different ones. And you can tinker with things you want as well or look at specific signals. So I hope that helps. Remember, you can use the DC technique for the control loop and the output impedance, so these two, but not for the input impedance. You must use the AC one, and it takes a long time, but it's the only way to get a more accurate AC analysis Bode plot.